AI has been getting more and more advanced every day with things like Stable Diffusion and OpenAI's new ChatGPT bot. I've been messing around with these tools and decided to attempt to make a game only using things generated by AI. My goal for this video is to create a game with only AI-generated art and code, and I'm not allowed to edit the scripts provided in any way, and I can't add to or change the art other than giving them transparent backgrounds. To start making a game, we need an idea. I asked ChatGPT what I should make, and it gave me a very good idea for a game where you collect objects falling from the top of the screen. This is a relatively easy game to make that is definitely possible with just AI. But I also need to know what the falling object should be, so I asked for a theme for the game, and it gave me vegetables. I need to generate some images of vegetables and any other assets we may need, edit them to be game ready, then generate some code to get everything in motion. It's not common to start with the art when making a game, but for some reason that's what I did. To begin, I should explain what I'm using to make the art. Stable Diffusion is an image generation tool that uses text to create images by diffusing random noise into something that looks like what you want. If you want a more in-depth explanation, check out some links in the description. To generate an image, I put in a prompt that describes what I want as well as a negative prompt that describes what I don't want. The more words you use, the better, because the AI can get a better idea of what you want. I messed with some of the other settings and hit generate. This first generation wasn't specific enough, so it made several veggies. I wanted one per image, so I specified I want some broccoli, and it worked perfectly on the first try. For every vegetable I made, I brought it into GIMP and removed the background. This process didn't take very long, and soon I had several veggies to use in the game. They're not very consistent due to the style I went for, and I didn't feel like making a custom Dream Booth model just for some vegetables. We also need to make something to collect the vegetables. I quickly generated a little basket for the player to move left and right. The final thing we need is the environment. A simple pattern background and grass platform look pretty nice and fit the style very well. With all the art done, it's time to get coding. For ChatGPT to start coding. The first script we need is a player controller. I told it to write a Unity C# player controller for 2D that allows the player to move left and right. This provided a very basic movement script, but it used a rigid body which I didn't want. So I changed my prompt to tell it to use transform.translate, and it worked perfectly. I just want to point out how insanely well commented this code is, and the description explaining everything is super helpful, especially to those new to coding. I copied the script into the game, and it worked without changing anything. We now have a magically moving basket to catch the veggies. But if the veggies aren't moving, how are we supposed to catch them? I added a rigid body to the veggies to give them gravity so they would fall. I then asked ChatGPT to generate a script that could spawn random objects at a random X position and a set Y position. It generated a script that could spawn a random prefab, but the method to do so was never actually called. In the provided instructions, it told me I had to call the method myself. So I told it to modify the script to call the method every random amount of time, and it did so perfectly. After all this, I wanted to mess around a bit and see if it could use tooltips instead of comments for the variables, and it can. It even only puts tooltips on the public variables. With the objects spawning and falling, I needed a way for the basket to be able to collect them. So I told the bot to create a script that would destroy any object that collides with it that has the tag veggie, and to add to a score variable that is displayed with a TextMesh Pro text object. After asking it to fix the library it was using, the script worked perfectly, and we now have a functioning score system. But if you don't manage to pick up the veggies in time, the game should restart. So I asked the bot once again to create a script that resets the scene when a veggie hits an object. With that fourth and final script generated and working, the game is complete. ChatGPT may not be perfect, and it does generate unusable things occasionally, but it's a super helpful tool for prototyping and simple concepts or writing code that you've written 100 times before. Stable Diffusion is also a great tool for art, but it's not at the point where it would be amazing for creating games with only Stable Diffusion art. Advancements are being made in all sorts of AI technology, and maybe soon we can see entire prototypes being made with just a prompt. If you've made it this far into the video, you may as well subscribe. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.